everyone, it's Auntie Moki and Kylo, and we're here to tell you another story. The story is Bobby Knows Best, and it's written by Catherine Sully and Frank Endersby. Now before we start, okay, I'm going to warn you, Kylo might try to disturb me, okay? If he does, we're going to carry on with the story nonetheless. Or he might go running off. Okay, either way, we're going to have fun today. Okay, let's begin. Bobby Knows Best by Catherine Sully and Frank Endersby. Bobby's friend Scoot came rushing to the burrow to find him. "I saw a fox," said Scoot. "A real live fox." Bobby had never seen a fox.
"Wow," said Bobby. "What was it like?"
It was, said Scoot, "scary."
Bobby thought Scoot was boasting. Bobby and his friend Scoot.
When Scoot had gone home, Bobby went to find his mother.
"Mum," he asked, "have you ever seen a fox?"
"Oh dear me, yes," said his mother. "And I never want to see those big sharp teeth again," she added.
Bobby shivered.
"Stay away from foxes, Bobby," she sighed, "if you know what's good for you."
That's Bobby and his mum.
Mum's putting the washing away. Bobby went to find his dad.
"Dad, have you ever seen a fox?" he asked.
"Yes, son," said his father. "A fox's big ears can hear you before you can see him." "Stay away from foxes, Bobby," he warned, "if you know what's good for you."
Bobby shivered.
That's Bobby's dad. Looks like he's collecting carrots for dinner.
Bobby asked his grandma,
"Grandma, have you ever seen a fox?"
"A fox?"
asked his grandmother, who was a little deaf.
"I've seen a fox, all right. I've seen his big, sharp claws."
Bobby shivered.
"Stay away from foxes, Bobby," she advised, "if you know what's good for you."
So here's Bobby meeting his grandma to ask her if she's ever seen a fox.
Bobby went to find his grandpa.
"Have you ever seen a fox, Grandpa?" he asked.
"Oh, yes. If you see a fox, lad," said Grandpa, "this is what you do. Stay very still. Find the nearest bolt hole. Then thump your foot to warn the others and run for it. Don't run in a straight line. Go in a zigzag. That'll slow old Mr. Fox down all right."
Bobby shivered. So that's Bobby and his grandpa. That night, Bobby lay in bed. Everyone had a story about a fox except Bobby.
"I've got big ears too," he thought, "and big claws and teeth. I'm not scared of a fox."
So Bobby crept out of the burrow in the moonlight and set off on a fox hunt. So here's Bobby in bed, thinking about how he didn't have a fox story. And here's
here's a picture of him creeping out of his burrow, hoping to catch a glimpse of Mr. Fox. The next morning, Bobby's mum called and called him for breakfast. She looked all around the burrow, but he wasn't there. Word soon went around the warren. No one had seen Bobby. Finally, Scoot had a suggestion. I've got a funny feeling, said Scoot quietly, that he might have gone looking for a fox. A search party was organized. So here's Scoot telling Bobby's mum that Bobby may have gone in search of the fox. And here's the search party. Scoot was right. Bobby sat in a corner of the meadow, his ears wiggling and his nose twitching, because in the other corner of the meadow, there was a fox. Now Bobby could see for himself. The fox's ears were pointier than Bobby's. The fox's teeth were sharper than Bobby's. The fox's claws were longer than Bobby's. Now Bobby was scared. Mum had warned him to stay away from foxes, and so had Dad and Grandma. Why, oh why, did he think he knew best? Just then, out of the corner of his eye, Bobby saw a familiar pair of eyes. Scoot's come to find me, thought Bobby, and now he's in danger too. Uh-oh, this is getting scarier and scarier. Bobby fixed his eyes on the fox and sat very still. The fox sniffed the air. More ears appeared above the grass. The rabbit search party spread themselves across the meadow. The fox was confused, but Bobby knew what he had to do. He remembered what his grandpa had told him. Look at Bobby, he looks scared, doesn't he? And all the other rabbits have come to look for him. Fox is confused. Bobby spotted the nearest bolt hole. He thumped his foot. At the signal, all the rabbits set off, running in every direction towards bolt holes hidden around the meadow. Bobby ran for his life, zigzagging to give the others time to get away. The fox chased this way and that, but he wasn't quick enough. Bobby dashed down to the nearest bolt hole. Ooh, looks like Bobby got away in the nick of time. The fox is right behind him. Back at the burrow, Bobby waited for his mum and dad to tell him off. But they were just happy that everyone was safe. And even Grandpa said, "Well done, lad. You slowed Mr. Fox down all right." Later, Scoot came over. "You were really brave," said Scoot. "What a great fox story to tell the others." "Yes," agreed Bobby. "But I think I'll stay away from foxes from now on. It was scary." The end. So that's the story of Bobby Knows Best. Okay, let's look at some of the words we learned in this story, shall we?
Words to learn. Burrow. A burrow is a hole or a tunnel dug by a small animal to live in. Warren. A warren is a network of lots of burrows. Bolt hole is a hole or place an animal can get to in a rush if it wants to hide. Boast is to speak highly about oneself. Shiver. To shake when feeling cold,
We also shiver when we are very scared. Search party. A group of people who get together to go in search of someone or something. Familiar. We say something is familiar to us if we have heard of it before or it is known to us. Zigzag. A zigzag is a line that runs from left to right and then to left again. Meadow is a field or grassland. Sigh is to let out a long breath that can be heard by even someone standing close by.
Questions about the story. Several characters in the book told Bobby their story about a fox. Who was the first character? Thereafter, who did Bobby go and meet to ask about their chance meeting with foxes? Why did Bobby shiver every time he heard a fox story from each of these characters? Grandpa advised Bobby about what he should do if he saw a fox. What was Grandpa's advice? Why did Grandpa advise Bobby to run in a zigzag? Where was the fox when Bobby first saw him? Bobby noticed some differences between himself and the fox when he first saw him. What were they? Ultimately, how did Bobby describe his own fox story? Idioms. Idioms are short sayings or expressions that offer advice. The title of this story is Bobby Knows Best, which is a play on the expression Mother Knows Best. Bobby thought he was smarter than his mother and everyone else who advised him to stay away from the fox. So, instead of heeding their advice, he went out in search of the fox. He later realized he was being very silly and ought to have listened to their advice. He finally realized he didn't know best, his mother did. Here are some examples of idioms or idiomatic expressions. Can you try saying that phrase? Idiomatic expressions. That's right. Better late than never. No pain, no gain. Actions speak louder than words. Put your best foot forward. A rolling stone gathers no moss. What do these idioms mean? What advice do they offer us?
Okay, that brings us to the end of the story. Kylo is hungry and I'm a mess because he's gone to dig all kinds of holes all over the place and then comes back for a treat. Naughty boy. Okay, I hope you enjoyed Bobby Knows Best by Catherine Sully and illustrated by Frank Endersby. Thanks for joining us here at Storyland SL. This is Auntie Moki and Kylo signing off. Don't forget to follow us on Instagram. Our Instagram handle is StorylandSL. Like us on Facebook and of course, subscribe to this channel. Bye!